Whether you receive them as a gift or choose them yourself, living plants have become an essential part of holiday decor. Where once only poinsettias ruled, you'll now find many more options, from amaryllis and paperwhites to holiday cactus, cyclamen, moth orchids and hydrangeas. And, of course, you can even have a living Christmas tree. Here's what to do to enjoy your favorite gift and holiday decor plants well beyond the season. Poinsettia No flower defines the holiday season like the cheerful poinsettia, Euphorbia pulcherrima. It's known for its bright red leaves, which are actually bracts, although, these days you can also find them in shades of white, cream and pink, as well as bicolor versions. It's also long-lasting. Given the right care, it often will continue to bloom until the beginning of spring. If you're willing to do a little more work, you can also get it to re-bloom for several holiday seasons. During the holiday season, ideally, put your plant in a location that gets 6 to 8 hours of bright, direct sunlight. It also can handle darker spots for a few weeks. Keep it out of drafts and cold spots, and place it where it won't touch cold window glass. Daytime temperature should be between 65 and 80 degrees Fahrenheit, 18.3 to 26. 7 degrees Celsius. Water thoroughly when the soil is dry to an inch or so below the surface, then allow the container to drain completely. If you can, provide additional humidity, setting it on a pebble tray is ideal. Don't fertilize while the plant is blooming. One rule of thumb for any plant you have, remove the wrapping around the container, cheerful though it may be, or at least poke holes in the bottom to allow water to drain. An exception would be materials that are naturally porous, such as burlap. Post-holiday care. Give your plant the same care as you did during the holidays until the blooms fade, usually by March. Cut the plant back to about 8 inches high. Cut back on watering at this time as well, allowing the soil to dry completely between waterings. You can keep your plant indoors or move it outside in late spring into early summer once nighttime temperatures have warmed up above 50 degrees Fahrenheit, 10 degrees Celsius. Put it in a bright spot that gets indirect light in the mornings and partial shade in the afternoons. Resume regular watering when growth begins again, but be sure the container drains completely and the soil isn't soggy. Feed with a balanced half-strength fertilizer every 2 weeks. Pinch back stems to keep the plant bushy. You also may want to repot the plant if it's crowded. Bring your plant inside in fall, when nighttime temperatures fall to 50 degrees Fahrenheit, 10 degrees Celsius, again. Find indoor pots and planters in the house shop the trick to their red color. Poinsettias are short day plants and require an extended daily period of darkness over several weeks to trigger the change of leaf color from green to red. Place the plant in a location that's completely dark at night for a minimum of 12 to 14 hours and with nighttime temperatures of 55 to 60 degrees Fahrenheit, 12.8 to 15.6 degrees Celsius. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.